you. Whoever is without sin, cast the first stone. I'm guilty. I'm guilty of all of these phrases. I'm really guilty. So please, learn from my mistakes and avoid the following phrases. Imagine, tonight I'm going to talk about my 10 phrases. Boring. Don't say something we already know. Introduce you strong. Always call the attention of the people. Right? Number two. Once upon a time, I. This is all about the audience. Instead of use I, me, use you, we, us, and include all the audience. Include them, include the listeners. Number three. Sorry if, sorry for, I apologize, I forgot. The first thing that I learned in Toastmasters was to not apologize. So repeat after me. We never,
apologize.
Never. Why? Because this is a credibility killer. A real credibility killer, and we don't want that. And speaking about credibility killer, I'm not a good speaker, I have never done this before, I didn't have time enough to prepare the speech. Don't use these excuses. Just say your message, share whatever you want with us, and we probably will love it. Relax. Number five. I'm very, very guilty of this one. Basically. It's for me, sometimes I use it because I think you sound smarter. That is not true. I mean, it's annoying. Basically, every sentence is basically. So please, basically, don't use it. And the next slide shows, I have heard this one several times. The transitions are essential for our speeches, essential. So work carefully, trying to connect every idea in your speech, and avoid simply say, the next slide shows. Number seven, I have a funny joke. Oh, I have a good story. Don't get me wrong, the jokes and the stories are great, are a perfect element for your speeches. But don't announce them. Don't say before in front, it will be a funny joke. Let the people decide if the joke is funny or if the story is good. Number eight, I know this is a really busy slide. So why did you include it? Why? In the first place, all your slides you have to speak about everything in your slide in the time you have. So if you see something there is, just remove information, remove content, or remove the light, ultimately. Number nine. I think I bore you enough. I hope you haven't bored your audience at all. But if you have, do you really have to kill yourself? Please, no. That's all I have for you today. That's the same that you are saying. You know what? I don't care about conclusions. Keep always in your hand a conclusion, whatever it is, two lines. If you are running out of time, jump in your conclusions. But have one strong and call it to attention. Don't just say that's all I have. And a bonus track, because I have a lot of time, a bonus track for you is another way to end in a very awful way is this one. That's all I have for today. Oh, no, wait, sorry. I have to add something. What? I'm running out of time. Don't be tempted. The temptation is difficult, but avoid anything to include after your conclusion. Just finish and go to your seat, okay? So, please, learn from my advices and you will keep a better connection with your audience, and the audience will enjoy much more the speeches you have. But don't worry, if you are guilty like me, there are no perfect speeches. And guess what? That's all I have.